All right, guys, we're going to do a quick value study, and we've got three pencils to work with. One is your original number two pencil, like every pencil you've ever used, ever. And it's kind of hard to see on here because of the brightness, but it is just a nice gray pencil. I know, super exciting. Secondly, the 2H pencil. Now, what you got to remember is the H means lighter and the B means darker. So this here is the number two, or what we call an HB, right between the H's and the B's. It's an HB, the number two, the normal pencil. And then this is the 2H. And when I color with that one, you can see it's much lighter than the first one. I'm trying to use the same pencil pressure throughout the whole thing. But that is the 2H. It's so light, can't see it because of the light on the camera. And then this is an ebony pencil, which is in the range of about an 8B. And it is super, super dark black. And the reason it doesn't look super black right now is because of the shine from the light on the camera. But you'll notice when you experiment with it, it's really dark black. So you're gonna get one of these, a graphite value study sheet. And it is your chance to practice what a 2H looks like and what a number two looks like and what an ebony pencil. So the first thing I want you to do when you start, you're not starting now, you're just watching, you're going to write your name on it just like I am there. And then you're going to flip it around and start. So the first thing it asks you to do, I'm probably going to try to zoom out of, there we go. It says to draw an example of each lead in the circles. And you're going to start with light pencil pressure, and you're going to increase that pencil pressure as you fill in the square. So I'm going to start with really light pencil pressure. In other words, the amount of pressure I press my pencil against the paper. And as you can see, I'm going to increase it. Now, again, the video, I apologize, it looks really light. My example should be sitting right there, and you'll see that there actually is pencil on that first half of the circle. Now I'm using 2B, just like it says on your sheet, and you can see that one start off really light, and it will get darker too. And notice how the darkest edge over here on this edge right here is a lot darker than in the first circle. And then the last one, the big old ebony pencil. Make sure you've got the right one. There should be one for everybody once we start this. And you can see as this one starts to get dark in the middle when I'm really starting to press, it is much darker than the first two. So we've got five squares in front of you. Actually, they're rectangles. We have five rectangles in front of you, and we're going to go lightest to darkest. So I would obviously start with the lightest pencil in the lightest area. And I'm going to do some crosshatching, which means I'm going to go at this angle for a while, and then I'm going to go at this angle. And in the video, it looks like I'm doing nothing. But please look at my actual example, which should be right next to the monitor and that you're watching this on, and you will notice that there's actual pencil there going back and forth. Again, trying to adjust the brightness of this camera is tough sometimes. Now this one, I'm definitely coloring a little darker, and I'm using a little more pencil pressure. And so you're starting to be able to see some of that lightness as I go, and the pencil looks cool and fuzzy when we draw fast. Again, crosshatching is any time that we cross up or do lines in opposite directions. And for some reason, I usually do them at angles. And I'm just finishing off that square. Now that I'm in the middle, I was hoping that would help you see it better, but it doesn't. Now that I'm in the middle, I'm going to switch to that just regular old number two or HB pencil. And again, I just usually start on the edge right next to the last square I did, because my main purpose is to just make sure that this part is darker than the first part. So that's what I'm doing right here. I'm trying to make sure that this section is darker than the first section. Or the third section is darker than the second section. And I'm not doing quite as much of the cross-hatching because I'm pushing the pencil so hard, I don't really need to. The reason I did cross-hatching on the last one is because you're not pressing the pencil very hard, and to get it lighter, that makes it easy. Now I'm really pressing this number two into the paper, and that's why I'm getting this nice dark shade right now, and I'm also doing some cross-hatching. So when I combine the two, hard pencil pressure and cross-hatching, it gets even darker. Now for this last one, I'm going to switch to the ebony pencil. Again, the softer the lead, this has really soft lead in it, the more lead catches the texture of the paper, therefore the darker it gets. So in a 2H pencil at the very beginning on the light side, you get a much lighter pencil because less lead is being grabbed by the paper. And here you're getting much darker because a lot of lead is being grabbed by the paper. Now it's gonna shine a bit. Yeah, you're done, light to dark. All right, so notice 2H pencil toward the lighter side. Somewhere in the middle, you can experiment with what you want. The two, number two, and then the ebony at the end. So now, yay, it's your chance to try this. So please understand I'm doing a presentation on the other side of the room. So if you could do this project silently, it would be greatly appreciated. Make sure to put your name on it. Also, make sure to take your time and do your best work.